In this video, you'll see how you can use AWS Resilience Hub with Terraform. You'll learn how to upload Terraform to Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3, run Resilience Hub against the Terraform bucket, and submit the application. We'll begin in Amazon S3, where we have already configured a bucket for the purposes of this demonstration. As you can see, our bucket contains a Terraform state file. Now let's go to AWS Resilience Hub and add our application so we can assess its resiliency. As you can see, Resilience Hub now has an option for adding Terraform state files. Let's choose this option and then select our S3 bucket. Next, we'll select the Terraform state file. Let's name the application and continue. Our Terraform state file has imported, and now Resilience Hub is loading its resources. Next, let's select the ECS service for inclusion. Next, let's select a policy. Resiliency policies define the recovery time objective, or RTO, and recovery point objective, or RPO, used to measure an application's resiliency to certain disruption types. For our purposes, we'll choose the mission critical policy. Next, let's review the information and publish the application. Now that the application has been published, let's run an assessment to uncover potential resiliency weaknesses. The assessment shows that our resiliency policy has been breached. Let's take a closer look. We can see the RTO is unrecoverable in our region. Next, let's view the resiliency recommendations. The recommended changes include adding auto-scaling groups and capacity providers in multiple availability zones, or AZs, adding a service replication in another region, changing the desired count of the setup, and configuring Amazon Elastic Container Registry, or Amazon ECR, replication to copy images to ECR in other regions. You've just seen how you can use AWS Resilience Hub with Terraform. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.